Hello students, how are you? Okay, today we are going to see 12th standard computer science, more on MySQL lesson. Okay, you see there are two tables are there. Okay, the first table is traders, the column names are T code, T name and city. Okay, then second table is there, the table name is items, the column names are code, item name, quantity, price, company and T code. Okay, so last class also we saw the same table, but in this class I gave a SQL query. Okay, for this you have to write the output. See, in this class I gave the SQL query. According to the query you have to write the output. Shall I write? Okay, listen, very simple. Select from in between, what is that? Max price and min price. So these two are called as column name. You see, this is one column, this is another one column. Okay, once again I will say, between select and from, okay, two things are there. The first one is column name and the second one is also another column name. Got it? Okay, so you have to draw the table with how many columns? Yes, two columns. Okay, write the same thing. Okay, max price, max bracket price. Then for the second column, min price, right? Min price. You see what is that here? You see you write here. What is that here? The same you will write here. Got it? Okay. You see, these two are called as aggregate functions. What is that? This max price is a one more question. Max price, min price, this were called as aggregate functions. Okay, fine. So first we have to go to the price column. Okay. First we have to choose which table. This table or this table? You just say which table we have to use. Yes. From after, what is this? This one is called as table name. So we have to see the items table. Okay. Then we have to see the price column. We have to see the price column. Then max price means take the maximum price. The maximum price is 38,000. Got it? So you just write here max price under 38,000. Okay, min price means go to the price column. Where is the minimum price? The minimum price is, I think, 1200. Okay, so that 1200 I can write 1200. That's all. This is the output. Okay, so between select and from, what is that? The same you can type as a column name. Then max price means choose the maximum price, min price means choose the minimum price. That's all. Understand? Shall I go for next question? Okay. So, okay students, now we are going for the next question. The second question is, select price into quantity in the name of amount from what table name? Items table name, where the code is equal to 1004. Okay, if you saw the question means, okay, if you saw your question with a condition means, see, directly you have to see the condition, this part. Okay, don't see this part at all. Okay, whenever if you saw a condition means, you directly see the where condition. What is the condition? Code is equal to 1004. What is that? Code is 1004. That means, you see which table along, we have two tables. Which table? From afterwards, item is there. So we have to choose this item table. Okay, fine. So code is equal to 1004 means, code is equal to 1004. So this line only you have to see. Okay, so no need to see first line, second line, last line, before line. You have to see only this line. Okay, fine. Now, select is there, from is there. Okay, in between select and from, what is there? Price into quantity is there. Okay, so price and quantity you have to multiply. You see, because of the stock, you have to multiply. Okay, fine. So in the output, you have to denote in the name of amount. Okay, if you may got confusion, I will explain you. Between select and from, what is the price in the country is there, but you should not write in the table, you have to write only this amount. Okay, a table with your column name, price in the quantity I have to write, or amount I have to write, which one I have to write first? See, now, what do I say? In the table or column, price into quantity is written, otherwise, amount is written. Yes, correct. You see, price into quantity is usually written. Okay, now, what do I say? Amount is written. This part you should not write, only amount you have to write. Okay, so amount you have to write. Amount. Okay, right. Price in the quantity means, I told you we have choose 20,000 for in the line la mattum. Okay, you have to choose this price and quantity. 2150 is a price and 50 is the quantity. 4,000 fourth line. Okay, so these two you have to make it multiply. So what is the answer? Okay, let me check it. So 50 into 2,115. So 50 into 2,115 is equal to, the answer is 1,07,500. So here you are right, 1,07,500. Okay, this is the answer. So what to do? Select from price, and first you have to see the condition. Only you have to see the 1,004th line. Okay, what is the column name? Price into quantity. The answer is 1,07,500. Okay, so we can write the answer. What is the column name? Since after the price into quantity, they had given this amount. So that amount only you have to write here. Okay, suppose you may ask, sir, suppose the amount is particular. Suppose they have not given the amount means, you have to write the price into quantity here. The price into quantity comes to amount particular. This amount only you have to write here. Understand? Okay, shall we go for next question? Right. So, okay students, now we are going for the third question. The question was very simple. Select distinct T code from items table. Okay, so among the two tables, which table you have to choose? Yes, items table means you have to choose this table. Okay, then you see select and from. In between, is there any comma is there? No comma, such that this is a single column. This line denotes a single column. Okay, which column? T code column. So in item table, T code column. So in item table, you have to choose T code column. Okay, fine. So how you have to draw means, here between select and from, there is no comma, no comma, so that you have to write what? No need to write distinct, you can write only T code. Okay, then what is the meaning of this distinct means? It should not be repeated. Anything if you say means, that should not be repeated again. Okay, in T code, T01 is repeated, but instead of two number, you have to write only one T01. T02 is repeated. Instead of two, you have to write only one time. Then T03 you have to write. Got it? So below the T chord you have to write T01, T02 and T03. Okay, suppose distance kudutho neenga T01 T01 ezhudinga it is wrong. Am I right? Okay, so you have to choose, see the item table, then you have to choose the T chord column. Okay, remember carefully, in the distance inge ezhudha thevai illai, no need to write this distance in this part. Simply you can write this T chord alone. Okay, under that the name should, the T chord should not be repeated. Simply write T01, T02 and T03 here. So this one is the exact output. Got it? So hope you understand. Shall we go for next question? Okay, right. Okay students, let me see the fourth question. Select I name comma T name from items I comma traders C where I dot T code is equal to T dot T code and quantity is less than 100. Okay, first of all you should understand what they are giving. So listen very carefully. Select I name. Where is I name? Just show me. Here? Yes. Here is I name. Okay. So this I name is from items table. Then T name. Is there any T name here? No T name. Can you see here? Yes. So this here I name is in items table. And T name is in trade table. Okay, I name in item table and T name in traders table. Okay, so that in this query we are joining the two tables together. Okay, from items comma traders. So these two columns are belongs to two tables, namely items and traders. Okay, and what is this I, what is this P mean? Very simple. Items, the shortest form is I, and traders, the shortest form is T. Okay, hereafter, T means traders. Okay, fine. You see, I told you, whenever you want to see, you want to write the output for your query means, always see the condition. See the condition first. Where is the condition? Quantity should be less than 100. Okay. See.
I'll erase this one. It makes some confusion. So I will erase this one. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So listen. Quantity is less than 100. Where is the quantity less than 100? More than 100? Less than 100? And less than 100.
Okay.
Okay, fine. So only these two lines only you have to consider. The 78th line, then the 50th line. Only these two lines you have to consider because the quantity should be less than 100. Okay. Then I dot T code is equal to T dot T code. What is the meaning of this one means? Very simple. Listen, first you draw a table. Let me explain you later. Okay, first you draw the table. How many column between select and from? Is there any comma? Yes, comma is there such that two columns are there. The first column is I name and the second column is T name. Okay, so according to our selection, the I name is LED screen. So here you can write LED screen. Then according to LED screen, which one is the T name? What is the T name? You see, LED screen or the corresponding T name N. You see, is there any connection between items and traders? Yes, there is a connection between items and traders. In the T column, The T code is nothing but that T01, T02, T03. And here also T code is there, T01, T02, T03 is there, such that this T code and this T code will make a connection between the two tables. Okay? Right. So LED screen, the T code is T02, and come here, where is T02? T02, the corresponding T name is DISP-INC. So here mark that rule. You are right? DISP-INC. Purida laya? See, LED screen on a corresponding IT name N. LED screen on the LED screen on a T code is T02. You come to T02, and the nearer is that DISP-INC in the T name here. That's all. Okay? Over. And coming to the next one, car GPS. Car GPS is the I name. Car GPS is the I name. The corresponding T code is T01. So here they come, where is T01? Here is T01. Then the corresponding car GPS T name is electronic sales. So car GPS T name, it is electronic sales, right? Electronic sales. Original, yeah. Car GPS, go to T code T01, come here T01, the corresponding T name is electronic sales, you write here. So for this query, this is the output. Understand? Right. So any doubts, please, you can call me at any time. I'll explain you. Okay? Fine. Shall we go for the next question? Right. So, okay, students. In this case, I have given some information. And I have given some output here. Okay? So, according to the information, you have to write SQL query. According to the information, you have to write what? SQL query. So, query means, you see, so let's start from, it's a query, okay? So, you have to write the SQL query according to the information and the output, okay? Fine. So, just to see the output, if you see the output, you can have an idea. What is this T01? They had given two. Okay. So T01 is appeared one time. Okay. And here T01 was appeared two times. Okay. So T01 is appeared two times. Okay. So in this case, you have to consider either parent table or item table. Here T01 appeared one time and that T01 appeared two times. Here they have given T01 2. So you have to choose one in the item table. Clear? Okay. Now you have to write the SQL query. Whenever you saw display, you have to write, simply close your eyes and write select. Okay? Fine. T01. I told you to choose the item column. In that, what? T01 means what? T01, the column name is T code. Super. Here you have to write T code. Comma. What is this? This T code count, number of count. So here you have to write count of the same T code. Here what you write? The same you have to write here also. Understand? Okay. So this is T code and this is count of T code. From which table? Traders table or items table? Yes. So since T01 is appeared two times, so we have to choose item table. So here items. Okay. Then from items, okay, listen carefully. This T01 and this T01 should be grouped together. After the grouping only, we can say T01 group, there are two numbers are there, we can say. Okay? so that these two T01 we have to group together, and T02 we have to group together, and T03 alone we have to group. Got it? So at last you have to write group by column name. What is that? Group space by column name. Group space by, use the space here, by what is the column? T code column. At last, don't forget to give the semicolon. You may ask you, sir, yedhukku sir group by kodukuringa? What is the need? You see, T01 count 2 abinu varanum appadina kandipa இந்த ரெண்டு T01-ஐயும் நம்ம குரூப் பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் தான் கவுண்டே பண்ண முடியும். ஓகே, யூ சீ இன் எ கிளாஸ் தேர் ஆர் சோ மெனி ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர். பாய்ஸ் எத்தனை, கேர்ள்ஸ் எத்தனைன்னு கவுண்ட் பண்ண வச்சுக்கோங்க. பாய்ஸ்னா தனியாக போய் நில்லுங்க அப்படின்னு பாய்ஸை குரூப் பண்ணுவோம், கேர்ள்ஸ்னா தனியாக போய் நில்லுங்க அப்படின்னு கேர்ள்ஸை குரூப் பண்ணுறோம். தென் ஒன்லி யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி கவுண்ட் த நம்பர் ஆஃப் பாய்ஸ் அண்ட் நம்பர் ஆஃப் கேர்ள்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் ஆஃப் separate, you see, first step is we have to group separately and then we have to count. So T01 na nam group pandrom, then we can count. T02 na nam group pandrom, then we can count. Then T03 group pandrom, then we can count. Understand? So that's why only we are writing group by. Between group and by here we have to give space. At last you have to write that T code. Don't forget to give the semicolon. That's all. So for this question, for this output, this is the SQL query. Understand? Shall I go for next one? Thank you very much. So, okay, my dear students, I'm going to give an important information. Please listen carefully. You see, this is the last year computer science guide. Okay, in the guide the seniors vechirukanga, please get this guide from your senior. Okay, fine. Then if it is available you can get the guide directly, otherwise you can take xerox from it. Okay, you see, after some 4 pages there is some page is that unit 5 communication technologies, that starting from evaluation of networking up to introduction to web services. Okay, this part is added in your syllabus in old computer science guide. Take the unit 5 communication technology starting from evaluation of networking ending with introduction to web services. All these topics are included in your syllabus. Okay, so please take xerox for this one. Okay, then you can read. Okay, so hope you understand this class, and thank you very much.